Hello, friends, and welcome back. And today, oh, first of all, Happy New Year 2021. It's going to be great. Take my word for it. What I've got here today, and I am excited about it, in my opinion, the perfect Gibson SG. Is it an SG custom or is it a Les Paul custom? Because it says Les Paul on the truss rod cover and on the little plate at the neck joint down here. Well, this from our friends at Gibson's Custom Shop is a reissue of a 1963 SG / Les Paul custom. And the story behind all that is, when the SG shape was first introduced in 1961, it was a Les Paul. Les Paul didn't like it, and he wanted his single cutaway back, which Gibson was having a hard time selling at the time. This was a popular guitar when they introduced it. Les Paul didn't like it for several reasons, and he asked that his name be taken off of it. And in 1962, that was when his contract was up. But throughout 1963, they continued to put his name on the guitars just simply because they had the nameplates already printed out. And you know, believe me, I've been around that long. Back in the 60s, people were frugal. Even big manufacturers were frugal. So they continued to put this out with Les Paul's name on it through 1963 until 1964, when it was totally branded as the SG. But this also is part of Gibson's M2M program. It's a made-to-measure guitar because the catalog 63 SGs all had either the side pull vibrola or the Maestro vibrola, which they had just introduced in 1963, and they were pushing that hard. They were looking at this guitar as something to compete with the Stratocaster, and they knew people liked the whammy bar, so they wanted to have a thin, lighter guitar, still with great sounds, but that had that vibrola on it. Most people who bought it ended up taking it off, putting a stop tail on an ABR. So this one, we just decided, let's go ahead and do that from the very beginning. All in all, this is just such a beautiful guitar. My favorite neck carve, the 60 Slim Taper C neck. It is, of course, all mahogany body, mahogany neck. Ebony fretboard, and you know how the guys at the Gibson Custom Shop are. This is just finished impeccably, just fantastically. Three of the Custom Bucker Alnico 3 pickups on it, and there are a lot of things that are maybe not exactly vintage correct, but made it better. This does have the long neck tenon in it, which they didn't introduce in the SGs till 1964. But on this model, being a made-to-measure guitar, it does have the long neck tenon in it, has the ABR1 beautifully gold-plated here, along with the stop tail, the pickup covers on the custom buckers, CTS pots, Black Beauty capacitors in here, the gold Grovers with the kidney buttons on them, just sweet. And, of course, the Gibson split diamond that they used on their custom guitars at the time. This is just incredible. And not only does it sound just excellent, I mean, three very usable pickup positions on here with a lot of three pickup humbuckers. That middle one is kind of extraneous because it really doesn't fill a slot here. And it could be because if you noticed, In the 1963 Gibson catalog, which I did look up, the center pickup had the pole pieces up toward the neck. On this one, it's got them down toward the bridge, and you've got a very... nice difference in tone, even with a higher gain setting like I've got here. Let's go over and take a listen to it clean here, because SGs just have a great clean sound to them. Here is the bridge pickup on here, volume and tone all the way up. And you can just hear that chime and openness from these unpotted custom buckers. I got to do that again. That's just killer. Okay, middle pickup position. And the neck position. Well, even this guitar has so much character to it. And I gotta say, back when I was 12 years old and all my friends were dying for Strats and Les Pauls, this is the exact guitar I wanted. I thought the SG Custom was the coolest guitar in the world. And here we have one that has the perfect balance of authentic vintage specs and some of the modern improvements that they did to the SG over the years. And although I'm generally not a fan of relic guitars, especially heavily relic, this is so tastefully done. Little touch on the belly carve, little bit of checking in the nitro finish. This doesn't look like it was drugged behind a truck. It looks like it's been played and loved for 50 some years. This is just gorgeous. We have only one, as far as we know, there is only one exactly like this. So if you're interested in this guitar or any of the other guitars you've seen online, please give the guys at moreguitars.com a call or visit our store in Evansville, Indiana, More Music. The guys here are the experts in every brand they sell, and they will match you up with the perfect guitar for your playing needs. These guys are great. We're all excited about the new year. We're very excited to have you as a customer, so please give us a call. Let's get the 2021 kicked off right, get a gorgeous guitar like this in your hands. And don't forget, follow us on Facebook. Subscribe to our YouTube channel, all that good social media stuff. And let's have a great 2021 and make a lot of music for each other. See y'all soon.